Millions of messages are sent and received every day, nearly all by wireless users, and the demand for wireless services is growing like wildfire. But so is concern about the potential health effects from long-term exposure to RF energy. The International Agency for Research on Cancer recently classified RF energy as possibly carcinogenic to humans based on limited evidence that RF energy might be a risk factor for cancer. However, the vast majority of scientific research to date does not support this link. Dr. Daniel Krusky is the scientific director of the McLaughlin Center for Population Health Risk Assessment.
You have to look at the entire body of literature when you're reaching overall conclusions, and of the literally thousands of papers that have been written on this topic, very few have suggested health concerns, and all of that information needs to be taken into account when reaching an overall conclusion.
Levels of radio frequency energy that are coming from cell phone technology are typically well below the safety limits.
If you're being exposed to cell phone technology or just the phone inside the house, which is a hand-free technology, remember again, you're going to be exposed from that little base station that you plug into the wall in your home. You're going to be exposed just as much as you are from cell towers because the signal has to get to you. And then you're going to send a signal back. You don't have to send it back as far. You often don't send it back the width of your house. So the radiation dose from that handheld system will be quite low.
The limits set in Health Canada's RF exposure guidelines are actually 50 times lower than the threshold for potentially adverse health effects. These limits are based on ongoing research and scientific studies.
If you go back historically and look at how the standards and guidelines, SC6, how they evolved, it was taken into account the size of the individual. There were models done for children, for fetuses even. The standard and guideline, as it exists now, has evolved from considerations that have incorporated all of that over the last 50 years.
There are things you can do to reduce RF exposure, such as limit the length of cell phone calls, using hands-free devices, or texting. Since children are typically more sensitive to a variety of environmental agents, parents are encouraged to reduce their kids' RF exposure from cell phones. Remember, all equipment associated with exposure to radio frequency fields must meet Health Canada's safety guidelines. Also, Health Canada continually reviews scientific studies to ensure that safety guidelines are sufficient. For more information, visit healthycanadians.gc.ca.